Welcome to Maths Educators YouTube channel. Before we start studying, I would request you to watch this video till the end so that you don't miss any important points. So let's start studying biology.
Hello students, welcome to Maths Educator. Today we are going to explain 12th standard biology, chapter number 11, that is biotechnology, its principle and processes. In this chapter, we have already completed about some introductory point, the principle of biotechnology, and we take a tools of recombinant DNA technology. In that, we have completed restriction enzymes and cloning vector. Now, in today's lecture, we are going to learn about something interesting, that is the insertional inactivation. Okay, as you know, insertional inactivation, insertional means ki hum kahin pe add kar rahe hain, aur inactivation means ki kisi ki activity ko hum stop kar rahe hain. So over here, the most efficient method of screening for the presence of recombinant plasmid is based on the principle that the clone DNA fragment disturb the coding sequence of a gene. In short, कि हम जिस cloning में जो cloning vector है इसमें जो हमारा desired DNA है उसको हम अगर add कर रहे हैं तो फिर हमें कैसे पता चलेगा कि कैसे वो recombinant हुआ है कि नहीं हुआ है. For that, insertional inactivation is the most important things. कि यहाँ पे हम क्या कर रहे हैं कि किसी भी ऐसे coding gene को हम इनएक्टिवेट कर रहे हैं और वहां पे हमारा इंटरेस्टेड डीएनए लाइगेज कर रहे हैं, तो उससे क्या होगा कि उस जीन के एक्टिविटी स्टॉप हो जाएगी. दैट विल बी गिव सम इंडिकेशन. सो द मोस्ट एफिशिएंट मेथड ऑफ स्क्रीनिंग दैट इज द इंसर्शनल इनएक्टिवेशन इन विच द प्लाज्मिड इज बेस्ड ऑन द प्रिंसिपल दैट क्लोन्ड डीएनए फ्रेगमेंट दैट डिस्टर्ब द कोडिंग सिक्वेंस. हम जो भी डीएनए फ्रेगमेंट को हम कोड कर रहे हैं वो किसी कोडिंग सीक्वेंस को डिस्टर्ब कर रहा है, एंड दैट टर्म इज नोन एज द इंसर्शनल इनएक्टिवेशन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द पावरफुल मेथड ऑफ स्क्रीनिंग ऑफ फॉर द प्रेजेंस ऑफ रिकॉम्बिनेंट प्लाज्मिड इट्स अ ब्लू व्हाइट सिलेक्शन. इन दिस मेथड, इन ब्लू व्हाइट सिलेक्शन मेथड दैट इज बेस्ड अपॉन द इंसर्शनल इनएक्टिवेशन ऑफ लैक जेड जीन. कौन से जीन का हम यहां पे इनएक्टिवेशन कर रहे हैं? लैक जेड जीन दैट आर प्रेजेंट ऑन अ वेक्टर. द लैक जेड जीन एनकोड्स द एंजाइम बीटा गैलेक्टोसिडेज. व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ दिस जीन, जेड जीन दैट एनकोड्स द एंजाइम और प्रोड्यूस, दे आर एबल टू प्रोड्यूस द एंजाइम बीटा गैलेक्टोसिडेज दैट क्लीव अ क्रोमोजेनिक सब्सटेंस इनटू द ब्लू कलर प्रोडक्ट. ओके, वापस से बता रही हूं कि यहां पे इन दिस मेथड लैक जेड जीन दे आर एबल टू प्रोड्यूस बीटा गैलेक्टोसिडेज एंड दिस एंजाइम इट्स दैट क्लीव द क्रोमोजेनिक सब्सटेंस एंड कन्वर्टेड इनटू द ब्लू कलर प्रोडक्ट. ओके, सो इफ दिस लैक जेड जीन इज इनएक्टिवेटेड बाय द इंसर्शन ऑफ टारगेटेड डीएनए फ्रेगमेंट द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द ब्लू कलर विल बी प्रिवेंटेड. अगर हम इस लैक जेड जीन के जगह पे हमारा इंटरेस्टेड डीएनए का जो फ्रेगमेंट है उसको इंसर्ट कर रहे हैं तो उससे क्या होगा कि इस जीन की जो इफेक्टिवनेस है वो चली जाएगी. ओके, तो जो ब्लू कलर डेवलपमेंट हो रहा है वो प्रिवेंट हो जाएगा एंड इट गिव्स द व्हाइट कलर्ड कॉलोनीज, बिकॉज जो क्रोमोजेनिक सब्सटेंस प्रोड्यूस हो रहा था विद द इफेक्ट ऑफ गैलेक्टोसिडेज वो इफेक्ट नहीं रहेगा. Okay, so that will create a white color colonies, and by this way that can be differentiate between recombinant and non-recombinant. How they can differentiate? Look over here. Suppose this one is the vector. Okay, this one is our interested vector in which we want to insert our DNA fragment DNA. This blue color that indicate the lag Z gene. Okay, now if this lag Z gene is present as it is, so they will create a, they will form a mRNA. Because of that thing, lag Z gene will create a lag Z protein or known as a beta galactosidase protein, and because of that protein that produce a chromogenic substance that is in a blue color, and because of that thing that colonies are visualized as a blue. But when we over here apply insertional inactivation method. So यहाँ पे जो Lexed gene है blue color का, उसको हमें cut करना पड़ेगा with the help of restriction enzyme and inserted our interested DNA. तो उससे क्या होगा कि जो Lexed की जो mechanism है वो stop हो जाएगी. And because of that things, beta galactosidase enzyme produce नहीं होगा. There is a prevention for the functioning of beta galactosidase. So in short, non-functional protein is produced that will create a white colored colony as observed in this figure. Okay, so this is the method for the screening of recombinant and non-recombinant. If recombination is done, that will show a white colored colonies. So hume pata lag jayega, like white color colony if observed, that means our interested DNA fragment are there, and if blue colored colony only appear, that means our inserted DNA is not there in that particular cell. Okay, so this one is the best selection or screening method for that get differentiate between recombinant and a non-recombinant colonies. Now, vector for cloning gene in a plants and animals. अब तक के लिए हमने जो बात की, जिस vector के regarding बात की है, that all are in regarding to the bacteria. But now we talk regarding the vector that are mostly used for the plants and the animals. Why there are different type of the vector are we have to create in for the recombination in a plant and animal? Because plants and animals both are the eukaryotic cell, so they have a different mechanisms. Okay, they have a different structures, and because of that things, there are so many limited plasmids are there that could be used as a vector. For that, Agrobacterium tumefaciens, a pathogen of several dicot plant, is able to deliver a piece of DNA known as a tDNA that transform a normal plant cell into the tumor cell. What is the function of Agrobacterium tumefaciens? It's a one type of the pathogen for a several dicot plants, and because they deliver their DNA known as the tDNA, that will convert a normal plant cell into the tumor cell. This one is the characteristics of the Agrobacterium tumefaciens. And a direct this tumor cell to produce a chemical that required by the pathogen. Similarly, retroviruses in the animals have the ability to transform a normal cell into the cancerous cell. So as shown in this figure, this one is the picture of Agrobacterium tumefaciens, and when there is an infection of this bacteria to the plant, that will create this type of the tumor cell. Tumor cell in the sense, enormous growth of the cells. Okay, uncontrolled growth of the cells or a cancerous cells. So yahan pe kya ho raha hai ki us cells ke numbers badh rahe hain. Okay, so this ability to transfer this tDNA into the plant cell, because of that things, this Agrobacterium tumefaciens are used as a vector that used in recombinant DNA technology. The tumor, including TI plasmid of the Agrobacterium tumefaciens, has now been modified into a cloning vector, which is no more pathogenic to the plant, but it's still able to use that mechanism to deliver the genes of our interested into a variety of the plants. हम अब इसका किस तरह से इस्तेमाल करें, उसकी जो pathogenic उसके जो characters है उसको eliminate कर रहे हैं by using a recombinant process, and we just used their pathogenic उसका जो mechanism है deliver gene deliver करने के, सिर्फ उसी को ही हम इस्तेमाल कर रहे हैं. तो it's a disarmed new ones. Okay, it's work as a disarmed Agrobacterium tumefaciens. So the retrovirus has also been disarmed and are now used to deliver a desired gene into the animal cells. So once a gene of the DNA fragment has been ligated into the suitable vector, it is transformed into the bacteria, plant or an animal cell. As shown in this figure, this one is the Agrobacterium tumefaciens cell that possesses a TI plasmid. Okay, that TI plasmid that having the ability to transfer their gene into the plant cell. So we have to first isolate that TI plasmid, then recombinant that things by delivering or inserting our DNA fragment into that TI plasmid as shown in this. Okay, this one is a recombinant TI plasmid, जिसमें हमने ये orange color का हमारा जो रखा है, that is our interested fragment. Okay, then after we introduce that TI plasmid
into the plant cell by using this Agrobacterium tumefaciens. And as they are incorporated into the cell, they along with their plasmid, our interested gene can also be delivered into the plant. So that will be form a new strain of that plant. So how this Agrobacterium tumefaciens get delivered their DNA into the plant cell, because of that ability, we are using that Agrobacterium as a vector for the plant and the animal cell. So this is all about today's lecture. Thank you. Take care.
So if you guys have any doubts regarding whatever you have studied in this particular video, please do comment in the comment box. And if you want to join Maths Educator, you are just one call away from the number given on your screen. And one more thing, do not forget to like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel.